Hello.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
So can I start?
Yes, teacher, let us start.
Okay. A very good morning, students. Okay, screen is visible to you, everybody?
No, teacher. Everybody?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay. Good morning, students. Today we are going to see English topic, English grammar topic. Okay, so the topic name is simple tenses.
Is it in horizontal?
Second one. First one is present tense. Second one is past tense. And third one is future tense. So there are three simple tenses. Present tense, past tense, and future tense. Okay?
Ma'am, excuse me.
Now what is simple tenses? Simple tenses. The yes?
Ma'am, am I audible to you?
Yes, yes, sorry.
Please keep your mobile in horizontal mode.
Okay, horizontal. Okay, okay. Okay. Is it okay, sir?
Yes, it is okay now.
Okay. So, in simple tenses, the verb simply indicates an action in the present, past, or future. Now, see here, in present, past, and future, the verbs which are there, which indicates the action. Okay, so we are going to see many examples. So, the words which simply indicates the action in present, past, and future, that are called as simple tenses. Okay. See, these are the example of present tense, past tense, future tense. You can see first example, I run every day. The word which is written in red, run, R-U-N, run. This is the verb which indicates the present tense. I run every day. Next sentence is past tense. I ran yesterday. Run, ran. And in future tense, how you will write the word? The base word is run, okay? So the base word is run. And in past tense, run becomes ran. And in future tense, run becomes will run. I will run tomorrow. I run every day. I ran yesterday. I will run tomorrow. Okay? So present tense sentence is I run every day. Past tense is I ran yesterday. Future tense becomes I will run tomorrow. So these words keep in mind. Okay, the base word run, in past tense it becomes ran, and in future tense it becomes will run. Okay, so present, past, and future tense. So you can see your childhood, okay? So when you were small, it was your past. Who will tell me when you were in your childhood, it was in your... Which tense it will come?
Past.
Past. Right now, what is going, and when you will become elder, when you will become, you will grow. So that time it will be your future. Okay, so it is past, present, and future. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
See. Now, what is present tense? What is present tense? Present tense talks about the action that is happening now. Whatever is happening now, right now, I am teaching to my students. So, that is present tense. Okay. I am reading book. I read book. This is your present tense. I read book. I cook food. I walk in the garden. Yes? So, see the subject plus verb. So, here you have to write proper verbs with the proper subjects. So, what are the subjects? I, you, we, and they, and he, she, it, and whatever names are there. Okay, so I, you, we, they. So by with this subject, the verbs becomes only verb. No S will come over there. So I read, you read, we read, they read. Okay, with cook, I cook, you cook, we cook, they cook. I walk, you walk, we walk, they walk. So like this is the formation of the starting sentence, subject plus verb. Okay, and if the sentence starts with he, she, it, or whatever with names, okay, so he reads, he cooks, he walks. Okay, she reads, she cooks, She walks. It reads. It cooks. It walks with the name. Okay. So these are the example of present tense. So these are the verbs. Read, cook, and walk. These are the verbs. Okay. But verbs also, when you will put S and when you will not put S, that you have to see. Okay. With the subject. It depends on the subject. So subject is I, you, we, they. So you don't have to put S to the verb. Okay. And if the subject starts with he, she, it, or whatever with the names, for example, Rishabh. Rishabh reads book. Rishabh cooks food. Okay. Jenny walks in the garden. So the names he, she, it, the verbs become, the verbs has S in it. Okay. And if it is only I, you, we, they, so the verbs will never have S. It shows what is happening now. Right now, what you are doing, that is present S. So simple words, right now, whatever you are doing, that is present tense. And you have seen how the verbs differs with the subjects. Okay. See here, you can see, have you seen a number line in Max? This is a number line. So zero is there, in middle zero is there. On right hand side, there are positive numbers, and on left hand side, there are negative numbers. Okay. So here also, it also indicates the tense also. So you can connect Max with English. So number line zero. Zero means your present tense. And the positive numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is your future. Okay, that indicates future tense. And on the left side, negative numbers. It indicates your past, that is already over. Past means the things which are over. Okay, then zero. Zero is your present tense. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. This is your future tense. The things which are going to come, the things which will happen. So that is your future tense. Okay. So we have seen present tense talks about the action that is happening now. Subject plus verb. Okay. Next. Now, you have to see this activity based on the present tense. Okay. What is wrong with this sentence? There are 5 sentences you can see on the screen. I sawed a flower. She jumped on the table. He wrote a letter. Suresh finished his homework. I bring rice for lunch. So you have to make it proper. So who will make the first sentence proper? I sawed a flower.
I saw a flower.
Okay. So this example is taken from past tense. So past tense, present tense, and future tense. So you have to think and you have to say. Okay. So I've given you example of present tense. But you can see about the past also. I sawed a flower. So present. So the correct sentence, you have to think. So I saw a flower. So somebody replied, I saw a flower. Okay. Second sentence, she jumped on the table. So how you will write this sentence? She jumped on the table.
She jumps on the table.
Okay, she With she, you have to put S with the verb. He wrote a letter. He wrote a letter.
He yes. writes a letter.
He write a letter. Okay. Very good. He writes or he write a letter. What will okay, you have?
Yes. He writes a letter.
He writes a letter. With he, the subject is he, she and it. Okay. If he, she and it is there, then you have to put S to the verb. Next, Suresh finished his homework. Suresh finished his homework. You make it in present tense, okay? Make it in present tense.
Suresh finished his homework.
Suresh finish his homework or Suresh finishes his homework. Suresh finish his homework or Suresh finishes his homework. What will come? See here. What I have explained you here. He, she, it names, reads, cooks, and walks. Okay, if names are there, then you have to put S to the verbs. So here what will come? Suresh is there. Suresh is the name. Okay. Suresh studied his homework. So what will be the answer? Suresh
finishes his homework.
Very good. Suresh finishes his homework. So F-I-N-I-S-H-E-D. Suresh finishes his homework. Next is, I bring rice for lunch.
I bring rice for lunch.
Is it a correct sentence? Okay, if you want to write in present, then it is a correct sentence. I bring rice for lunch. So first one, if you want to write, I sawed a flower. It is given in past tense. But if you want to write in past tense, it becomes I saw a flower. And if you want to write in present tense, I see a flower. Okay, see becomes saw in past tense. Next is she jumped on the table. So she jumps on the table. He wrote a letter. He wrote a letter. Suresh finishes his homework. I bring rice for lunch. Okay.
Excuse me.
Okay. So this same sentence, if you want to write in past tense also we will see. I saw a letter. If you want to write this in past tense, so how you will write in past tense? C becomes saw. So I saw a flower. Okay.
I see a flower.
Okay. And the next is she jumped on the table. So she jumped on the table. See, you can see the past words also. Here you will get an idea about the past tense. I saw a princess table. He wrote a letter. This is about past tense. Suresh finished his homework. I brought rice for lunch. I saw a flower. She jumped on the table. He wrote a letter. Suresh finished his homework. I brought rice for lunch. Okay, this is about past tense. These are the examples of past tense. And we have already done orally on present tense sentences. Okay.
Yes.
Next is future tense. So we are going to see some idea about future tense also. Future tense talks about the action that will happen after. Okay. What does the future tense talks? Future tense talks about the action that will happen happen after. So here the rule is subject plus will plus verb. So wherever it is a future tense, you are going to do. You have not yet started. You will do it in future. So whenever you write a future tense sentence, you have to add will in the sentence. And the verb will be in your present tense. I will sit. Okay, will you have to add, and sit is the present, sit is the verb which you will write in present tense only. So I will sit, you will read, he will sleep, we will study, they will talk, it will play. Okay, future tense is very simple, just you have to write will and the verb which is there in present tense. Okay, I will sit, you will read, he will sleep, we will study, they will talk, it will play. So future tense tells about the things which happen after, in future. Okay, so let's read words that are regular verbs. Shout out and read loudly. So we are going to see the verbs which are regular. Okay, regular means, see, for example, we can see here.
Ma'am, can I read?
Yes.
Ma'am, can I read?
Okay, yes, read this, what I have written.
Yes, let's read what that are singular verb. Shout okay. out and read loudly.
Okay, shout out and read loudly. So you are going to see, I'm going to give you some words. So you are going to shout out the words which are regular verbs. Okay, now what are regular verbs? We'll see the example over here only. See here.
Past, present, future. Before, now, after. Who get? Cook, okay. Cook and cooks, will cook.
Okay. So you can see present tense word. Present means now, past means before, and future means after. So this way you can keep in mind. Present means now, past means before, and future means after. Okay. Now regular verbs means the present word is cook. And in past tense, we just write ed in that. So these are regular verbs. Okay. Regular verbs means the verbs which is added only ed or d in the past, that are called as regular verbs. So cook, cooks, and cooked will cook. Okay. So this become, the word becomes same. Just you have to write ed in the past, and in future you have to just add will. So these are regular verbs. Okay, so what is the regular word in this? So will you say the word? You have to shout out the word which is regular. Regular verb. What is regular word in this? See what I have told you. Let's read words that are regular verbs. Shout out and read loudly.
Miss Cook.
Cook. Cook. Cook. Cook.
So in this, what are the regular words? What is the regular words?
Cook. Will cook.
The base word is cook. Okay. Cooked. It's not cooked. It's cooked. Okay, just practice. Say all of you, cooked. So now what is cook? And it's cooked. Cook, in present it is cook, and in past it is cooked. Okay, it is cooked and will cook. So these are the regular verbs. Next, who will read this? What is the next regular verb? What is the next regular verb?
Work.
Okay, so work. So how you will read this in present?
Work. No, works.
Okay. And in past tense, how you will read this word? Work.
Work.
Okay, and in future, how you will read this word?
Will work.
Will work. Okay. Okay, if I want to write she, so in present. Okay, so how I will write she work or she works?
She works.
Very good. And if I want to write I, then what I will write? Work or works? I work or I works?
I work.
Very good. If I want to write they, if I want to write they, so what I will write? They work or they works?
They work.
They work. Very good. And in future, how I will write the sentence with they?
They will work.
They will work. In past, I want to write the sentence with he.
He worked.
He worked. Okay. So this is about past, present and future. Present denotes you about before, now or after?
Before.
Present.
Now.
And what about, okay, and past denotes you about before, now or after?
Before.
And future?
After.
Okay, so the things which you have to keep in mind is you have to put ed in past. Second thing, in present the base word will come, base verb will come. Okay, and if the subject changes, you have to put s in the verb. If it is he, she, it or names, you have to put s in the verb. And in future, what you will add? In future, what you will add? You will add will. Okay, so this you have seen the best example in max number line. So 0 is your present tense, 1, 2, 3, 4 is your future tense, and -1, -2, -3, -4 is your past tense. The things which are already over, that is your past tense. 0, presently, currently, going on, that is your present tense. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, positive numbers denotes your future tense. Okay, will you tell me this lines? Will this line ends? Does this line ends? Or it goes on continuing? Now, this is the number line. Okay, after 5, it will be 6, 7, 8. So this line goes on continuing. Okay, and here also -4, -5, -6. So this is also continuing. So it is never ending. So your past and your future, we don't know how much it is. Okay, so it never ends. So whatever the negative things are there, it goes in past. Okay. Okay, so whatever negative negative numbers are there, it goes on in goes in past, and when okay tomorrow it will be your present. When you go in tomorrow, that will become your present. So it goes on your past, goes on increasing, present goes on increasing, and your future also goes on increasing. Okay, it is going to come, it is going to come, that is your future. Okay, so have you understood about the present, past and future tense?
Yes, miss.
And the use of subject plus verb. So with which subject you will use what verbs? So I have tried to give you the idea about the verbs which you can use with different subjects. Okay, so whenever you write the sentence, there are lots of grammar mistakes students make. Okay, so in that you have to think and write which word is suitable with the with this subjects. Okay, so that's all for today. So we have seen simple present, past and future tense. Okay, thank you students.
Thank you.
राधिका आर्या मयूर
यस सर
इज द लेसन ओवर बेटा
ओके सर
कुछ डाउट्स है आपको
नो सर
चलिए स्टॉप हियर
यस सर
ओके
बाय सर हैव अ गुड डे
बाय थैंक यू